There are a lot of buildings on campus that are not bird friendly at this point. Basically, any window that's reflective will have at least one bird collision. Recently, I'm getting into conservation biology and I want to do wildlife conservation now, trying to make it so that we can live with wildlife and the nature the way they did a long time ago. The birds can't tell the difference between the windows and their habitat, which they think is the trees reflecting on the windows. So they fly into it, and obviously their really light bones can't handle the impact and they die on impact. Volunteers and I went around and we just got some base data on how many birds were colliding with windows, what the high collision areas were. When you would walk around and you'd see a gorgeous yellow throat, you know, bright yellow bird on the ground, just completely helpless. That's heartbreaking. What we've been working on is try to reduce the collisions. I applied for this Creative Arts and Research Grant. This is the spot on campus that I tested on the window film, and that gave me the money to get some window film to see if they could maybe distinguish the window. At Temple, there are many resources like the Philadelphia Zoo, the Pennsylvania Audubon Society, both which I have been in contact with and working with for doing my research. That's definitely what's unique about Temple, is that it's in a big city, but it's also kind of a close-knit community where you can go and reach out to someone at the zoo and they're like, oh, you go to Temple, cool, yeah, let's figure out something to do, let's do some conservation work. Conservation is really a huge field. You can work in Pennsylvania, you can work in Philly, you can work in Africa. I traveled to South Africa. I would volunteer 6 days a week at a cheetah conservation facility, finding contacts and finding people who do what you do and how to get in their spot. It was also during the World Cup. I would literally burn every vuvuzela I could if I could. I would hear them day in and day out at my house. It's just a dream come true to be able to volunteer there for a couple months, even if it's slowly but surely, you know, one person can make a difference.